If you're paying $2,000 a month in rent or more, you can afford your own home. You're already paying a mortgage, your landlord's mortgage. In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can fire your landlord and how home ownership is not that far away. Before I get started, don't forget to click the subscribe button so you can get notified of tons more informative videos going over real estate, investing, and finance to help you grow your personal wealth. Something people never think about is owning a home is like a forced savings account. So let's say you spend $2,000 a month in rent and you rent that home for 2 years. You're gonna spend $48,000 in rent. Now, let's look at that and let's say your mortgage payment's $2,000 a month. Well, unlike rent, your mortgage actually goes towards something. It goes to pay down the loan on your home. So while your home value's going up, your loan balance is going down. And a good portion of that $2,000 a month goes to pay down that loan. So when you go to sell your home in a few years, guess what? You get that money back. So it is like living in your home for free or a dramatically reduced cost. So think about that. Why don't you own a home? If you feel you're ready right now to find out what you can get approved for, just click the link next to this video and we'll get in contact with you and help you realize your dreams of home ownership. Now, the concept of renting used to make a lot of sense because the barrier to own a home was really high. You had to have 10% down, you had to have perfect credit. There was all these things that people really struggled to meet. That isn't the case anymore. When even I was at the age of potentially buying a home and I looked at the market in 2006, I looked and I said, you know what? What is it gonna cost me to buy this condo? And I looked at the mortgage payment and I had to have 10% down and it was gonna be like $3,500 a month. And then I looked and I saw, okay, what could I rent a condo for in that neighborhood or even in that community? And it was $1,000 a month less. So even though I was in the mortgage industry at the time, I rented. So I don't want you to think that I'm fully against renting because I was pro renting just at a different time. Nowadays, you don't need 10% down and interest rates are no longer 6%. With interest rates in the 2%, that disparity, that rent to mortgage payment difference has never been narrower. To give you guys just kind of a good idea, something your landlord definitely doesn't want you to know is, believe it or not, $400,000 home loan with property taxes and homeowners insurance and all the things that are involved in a mortgage runs about $2,100 to $2,300 a month for a $400,000 house. Well, guess what? Here in Southern California, do you know what $400,000 houses are renting for? $2,500 a month. $2,500 a month. Whereas before, your rent versus your mortgage, you were paying way more on your mortgage, or to even have the rent get close to the mortgage, you had to put 20 or 30% down. You can now at the point with 3 or 5% down, get a mortgage payment with everything equal to or less than that rent you're paying for. So there is no longer that disparity. And we can thank this due to the historically low rates that we're seeing. And we've never had a time in history before where we've gotten low interest rates mixed with all the awesome first-time home buyer programs that are out there. You have 3% down options as a first-time home buyer. So if you haven't owned a home ever, or you even haven't owned a home in the last 3 years, you can put just 3% down and buy that home. So you don't need to worry about saving 10 or 20% down. So you don't even need to have a ton of money in savings to make this a reality. And you can even, if you have nice aunts or uncles or grandparents or even parents that want to give you a little bit of money, you can even have them gift you this money with no taxable occurrence to use that towards your down payment. Now, I know a lot of people, they really don't want to make that commitment. Well, you've already made a commitment. You've already made a commitment to pay a mortgage. It's just not your own. You're paying your landlord's mortgage right now, and you're paying that typically at a rate higher than what his mortgage payment is. And you're paying it at 100% interest because every dollar you give that landlord isn't going anywhere. It is going directly into his pocket that he's using to pay down his mortgage while his equity is going up. So think about that. You're in the house, covering the expenses. He's reaping all the benefits of his house going up in value while at the same time taking your rent money and using it to pay down his mortgage payment. So he's winning in both directions because what's gonna happen when he turns around and sells that house? Guess what? He's gonna get all that money back that his house went up in value plus all the money back that you spent in your rent paying down his mortgage. Because unlike rent, your mortgage payment actually goes somewhere. It goes to pay down your loan balance. And a lot of people never think of it that way. It's like a forced savings account. Because if my mortgage payment and principal and interest payments $2,000 a month, there's a good portion of that that is going to pay down that loan balance. And that's how real equity is created. Because not only is the value of the home going up, but what you owe on that home is going down the longer and longer you're in that mortgage for. And you know what? I get it. You don't want to make a commitment. Before I was married, I didn't know where I was going to be. I didn't know if I was going to be in Orange County or San Diego County or Riverside County. And so I kind of sat on the sidelines a little too long to make that commitment. It was at a time where interest rates compared to what the house would rent for were at a big disparity still. So I didn't have the opportunity that if I wanted to move out of that home in a year or two, that I could rent it for even close to what my mortgage payment was. Well, guess what? We're no longer in those days. With interest rates in the 2%, the mortgage payment on my buyer's homes is so close and many times less than what that house would rent for. So you, if you get a job transfer and you need to move out to an area for a little bit, or you know what, you decide that, you know what, I need a little bit bigger of a space and I'm gonna go ahead and rent and stay with my parents for a little bit while I save up for a bigger house. Well, guess what? You can rent out your house and you can be the landlord. And that person can pay your mortgage while your home value is still going up. So it's something that you don't have to make that major commitment for. And if you're ready today to stop paying your landlord and fire him, just click the link next to this video and we're happy to walk you through that process and answer any questions that you have. So what are you waiting for?